Excerpt from Introduction. Trial lawyers might be the least collaborative members of the human race. I should know because that was my profession for 16 years. When I worked as a lawyer, I assumed that how people communicated and problem solved was fine 80% of the time. In the other 20% of cases, litigation was effective, although it was expensive. It was the 80-20 rule, 80% of resources spent on 20% of the situations. The 80 seemed to be working together without any issues, and they didn't need to change. It was all about the 20, I thought. I used to think that what I enjoyed about litigation was the thrill of winning. I now realize that my passion was about remedying injustice and unfairness. After my work as a lawyer, I studied conflict resolution, and I thought I had found the holy grail to address the 20% far more cost-effectively and constructively through mediation than by litigation. It puzzled me, though, that few others saw what I saw. Private sector mediation was woefully slow, and I was starving. Money wasn't important to me. Eating was, though. So I did the unthinkable for a dedicated entrepreneur. I became a public servant using my mediator skills for workplace conflict. In my new role, I loved how my work could change participants' attitudes and their workplace environments. I preached the positive side of conflict like it was the gospel according to St. Pat. Then it struck me, having been exposed first as a lawyer and then as a mediator, to the different ways that people work together. Or don't, I realized the challenge was not how to address the problematic 20, but the 80%. Within that group, communication and problem solving is ineffective. We don't collaborate, even when we say we do. Why don't we? Because no collaborative process model exists for the 80%, only for the 20%. I suppose I always wanted to write a book, although I never thought I would. Now that it's almost complete, I'm struggling to explain here that this feels like I didn't have a choice but to write it. It sounds crazy, and yet, the series of life and career events that led me here. Things like being in two car accidents, either of which could have ended my life, make me think that the universe kept me around for this reason. On the other hand, perhaps it was the fleet of five argumentative kids in my house that drove me to write this book. Either way, the more I wrote, the more I became aware that my ideas are dramatically different from those of others in the fields of conflict resolution and mediation. As the contrast broadened page by page, my conviction grew that writing this book is exactly what I'm supposed to be doing with my life. A funny thing happens in mediation sometimes. At the end, participants wonder why they didn't resolve their situation sooner, and why they even needed a mediator at all. When people reviewed this book prior to its publication, they made similar comments. This is so simple. Why doesn't everyone just use this collaborative model as their first option instead of conflict resolution as their last resort? Why doesn't everyone see this? My hope is that when you listen to this book, it will change how you communicate, problem solve, and make decisions in all aspects of your life. If you're not open to that, it's probably a good time, as they say in the TV shows, for you to put the book down, back away slowly, and no one will get hurt. If you are open to learning a simple 6-step collaborative process, let's get started.